Mrs. Dalloway. Mrs. Dalloway. Teresa Dalloway. What does she say? Something. What? Her mind start there. Mrs. Dalloway going on an errand in June. I might start there. Mrs. Dalloway going on an errand on a day in June. Instead of soldiers marching off to lay the wreath in Whitehall. Is it the right beginning? Is it too ordinary? Mrs. Dalloway said something. Yes.
I should be fixing breakfast.
Daddy. Morning, Bug.
I'll read one page. At 7:15, I'll get out of bed. The time. Reading this morning of all mornings. On Dan's birthday. I'll make it up to him. I'll iron the good tablecloth. I'll set a big bouquet of flowers in the middle of the table and wrap gifts for him. I'll bake him a perfect birthday cake. Just one page. Mrs. Dalloway said,
7:45 a.m., time for weather on the 5. More summer weather for a June show. It's 68 degrees in Central Park right now.
The flowers.
Today is your day, Clarissa.
This is it, honey.
Oh, look at the sky.
I'm going to fill our house with hundreds of roses.
Yes?
Yes.
What was the line in the night? Flowers? Don't look in the mirror, Virginia. It doesn't matter. Today is a good day. You didn't look in the mirror. Today, I will write. Oh, I will write.
I'm on my way, Sally.
I'm cleaning the bathroom.
Great. I've checked the fridge off the list. Four shelves are clear. The kitchen's ready for the caterers. Can you take a look and see if it's all good?
Got it. Don't be gone long.
Oh, and the living room's all yours. Should we open the conservatory and let the air in? It's a beautiful day.
Clarissa, I have an appointment.
One of us has to be here at 3 for all the food. I'm just thinking ahead. Oh, this is the last time I hold a party here. 50 guests, what was I thinking?
You love it. Just to remind you, I have a lunch meeting, remember?
Right, I'll be back way before you go. I just have flowers to buy. I left you coffee.
My work is a party. I am a girl in a new dress about to go down to the party, about to appear on the stairs, fresh and full of hope. Today, I will write. Yes, today I will write. I'll open with a day like today, the air like it is in summer, early, earlier than this, fresh, calm, still, like the flap of a wave, yes, like the kiss of a wave.
She felt very young, at the same time unspeakably aged. She sliced like a knife through everything, at the same time was outside looking on. She had a perpetual sense as she watched the taxicabs of being out, out, far out to sea, and alone.
Wait. Pause. Like on the edge of a turquoise pool before you dive into the racket. I'm so lucky. I'm alive in Manhattan this morning in June. Me, on my errand. These trees, these perfect little leaves, how do they survive in those patches of dog dirt and wrappers? Ah, flowers to buy, a party to give. A room full of delicious food and flowers and people, witty and influential and brilliant people. And my old friend, the writer.
You're up too early.
I feel well.
Have you had your breakfast?
Yes, Leonard.
Liar.
I'm having coffee with cream.
It's far from enough, Virginia. I'm going to have Nellie bring you a bun and some fruit.
If you send Nellie in to interrupt me, I won't be responsible for my actions.
It doesn't have to be much.
I'll eat later. I woke up in the night with a new opening line. Food will bury it.
You will have lunch.
I will have lunch. Why are you looking at me like that?
The first time I ever saw you, you were as startling as a Velasquez. We were at your brother's rooms in Cambridge.
Leonard.
You were in a white dress.
20 years ago, and now?
Still regal?
I'm going to work.
All right, Virginia. And now, I'm going to soldier on here.
Today's going to be difficult. Going to be one of those days. I won't believe in myself. Showered and dressed, fixing breakfast for Dan and my boy. There, in my robe. I should. For Dan, he risked everything, and you're in bed? What's the time? Just one more page. She stiffened a little on the curb, a touch of the bird about her, of the jay, blue-green light, vivacious, though she was over 50.
I would have run when I was younger. 52, I'm 52. Whoa!
$3 for a dollar.
Just one. Can I just have this one?
Oh, you like them red? That's 50 cents.
Oh, it's gonna be one of those days. I never want it to stop.
Mommy, Mommy, wake up!
I'm not ready.
Shush. Mommy needs to sleep.
Why?
Shush. Come away, son. You guys, you got a job to do in the kitchen.
A suspense. But that might be her heart, affected, they said, by influenza. Before Big Ben strikes. There! Out it boomed. First a warning. Musical. Then the hour. Irrevocable.
Oh. Why am I always in a rush through the roil and shock of Washington Square? I'm gonna say to Sally, let's stroll over and sit on the benches beside the fountain when this party's over. Cool off. Frisbees. Rollerblades. Joggers. Volleyball.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.